Hello, good afternoon. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capelian Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Now today guys, what I'm going to show you is I will try to show you the ESP32 cam that I have. Okay, now this is my ESP32 cam. Okay, guys, as you can see, there is no USB connection in my ESP32. So one of your problems that you need to solve is how I am going to connect it to my laptop to be able to download a sketch program on it. Okay, so I find some solution by using an Arduino board. Okay, so here, as you can see, I have my Arduino board. Okay, now by using the Arduino board, I was able to upload a sample sketch program for this ESP32. So first, you need to do some physical connection. Okay, so what are the connections? So I will just give you fast details. Okay, first you need to provide a power supply. Okay, now the power supply for ESP32, of course, it will be 5 volts. Okay, so 5 volts and ground will be coming from the Arduino board. Then the next thing you need to do is provide an RX or a serial communication from Arduino board to the ESP32. Yeah, now you can do that by using the TX and RX of both of the board. Okay, so then you need also to do some shorting. Actually, I will show you in my laptop the connection that I have here. Okay, so let me show you. Okay, so this is now the connection. Okay, so in GPIO, I already explained 5 volts coming from Arduino board, then ground, of course, then the UOT and UOR are the TX and RX serial communication. Then also the ground, you have to short it in the GPIO0. Okay, so this is the connection in the ESP32 cam. Okay, in Arduino, so the connection is like this also. Now you need to connect the TX and RX. Okay, connect it and the ground. Okay, so I will show it to you. Then it will go there. Okay, so that is clear. Then the 5 volts, the power supply. So I have here the 5 volts and ground. Now, the ground and reset is shorted. Okay, so put a cable there, a short cable. Short it, okay? Then the 5 volts, you will connect it to the ESP32 pin for 5 volt. Okay, so this is the physical connection of the two devices. Okay, now again, I will show you now the interface, I mean the IDE program. Okay, so the IDE, the program, guys, as I said, don't worry about this because this program is available as a sample. All you need to do is launch it in your Arduino IDE. Okay, so this is the example program. Okay, but first you need to specify something in the preferences. Okay, in the preferences you need to specify this URL address. Okay, so actually this URL address, this is just the address of the ESP32 package. Okay, so that when you launch your IDE, it will try to get the package from that URL, then put it in the library. Okay, now to be able to install the package, then you have to go to your tools, then go to the go to the board manager. Okay, so in the board manager, you have to click it, then you will see, okay, go to the bottom, then you will see this ESP32 and ESP8266. If it's not installed, just click the install, so to install it. Okay, so when you installed it, the supporting files or documents will be available in your IDE. Okay, now another thing you have to do is to configure your board. Of course, first you need to select properly what board you are using. Okay, so okay, you will select it here, what board I'm using. Okay, then let me focus it. Okay, so now it is ESP32 rover. Okay, so just select it, then you go back to the tools, then the upload speed you need to change it to 115/200 frequency. Okay, then mode QIO. Okay, just select all this in the selection. Then of course one of the important thing also is to make sure the COM port selection. So try to select the COM port where your Arduino board is connected. Okay, so after that you can also check the serial monitor. Okay, now the serial monitor will give you the, okay, this is my serial monitor. Actually in the serial monitor it will give you the IP address. Okay, the IP address of your ESP32. Okay, so I will explain it later because my webcam is already streaming some video. Okay, so let me show you the program itself. Now in the program, what is important here, as I said, you don't need to worry about it because it's already written for you. These are example of the developers. Okay, now here we have here select model. Okay, so select model, by default all this model are commented, so all you need to do is uncomment the camera, that is the model of the camera you are using. Now the model of the camera you are using is this one, camera model AI Tinker. Okay, so uncomment that one. Okay, then the next thing you need to do is change the SSID or input the SSID and password for your existing router. Because I have a small router here, I just powered up to check this ESP32. So you have to provide the SSID and password, okay? Then you will see the code itself, okay? So those are the code. Then if you will be able to successfully load this, then you will see how your camera works. As you can see here now, my camera is already up and running, okay? So let me, okay, so there the camera, so my small camera is already working. Okay, so it's already streaming video. Okay, now let me go back to my program just to highlight something. Okay guys, when you check your program by clicking this verify, if there is no more problem, then if it will verify the code. If there is no problem, then it will say okay, complete checking. Then this is the upload button. Now when you upload, then make sure you will press the reset switch. Once you upload, then you see at the bottom there is some line saying connecting. Then when it is trying to connect to your ESP32, then you have to press that reset switch, okay, so that the uploading will be completed. Okay, so once it is completed, then you can go to the serial monitor. Then you will see, okay, as you can see here now, I have here the IP address displayed in my serial monitor. So you will see the IP address. Then when you know the IP address, that's the time to go to your web browser. Okay, then just type the IP address. Okay, then you will see the camera is already showing some streaming video. Okay, now guys, make sure your laptop is also connected to the router, okay, so that you can see your camera in action. Okay, so this is how you will test this ESP32 cam, because as I said, I'm planning to develop a home automation project. Now I'm planning to incorporate this ESP32. So I can use this to monitor a certain part of the house, or maybe it will monitor the door if it is open or closed. Okay, so this is how you are going to test this ESP32 development board with camera. Okay, so guys, again, this is a very good development board that you can incorporate in your home automation system. As you can see, I still have here my setup for my home automation. I have here this ESP32 development board. Then it will be this one will be added. Okay, so again, I hope I have given you an idea how are you going to test your ESP32 CAM, okay, by using an Arduino board. Okay, so thank you for watching this video, and again, Santos Capillion will always end the tutorial by saying God bless us all, and let's all be safe, and bye for now.